Okay, good morning. Welcome to month 11, year 1 of the AEW sim with Fire Parada. I have nothing planned yet for today, so we're going to build up from scratch. Let's have a quick first things first, let's have a look at the wrestlers. See who's in a position to fight and who's not. That's always a good place to start. Just getting set up on my end of my spreadsheets and stuff. So please give me 1 second. So we have the Beer City Bruiser is out for another 2 months. Jericho's fine, Cody's fine, Neville, Trent. Oh, perfect. Everybody's in good health. So we have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 match card already. But I want to have the Bucks fight. So I'm thinking having the Bucks defend the titles against Stevie Richards. No, Richards has his number one contender fight, so Richards is against Matt Jackson for the junior heavyweight titles also. Styles versus Omega. Cody. Versus Inoue. We had that one before. Let's have a look. No, we haven't. So Cody Rhodes versus Masao Inoue. It could be a fun one. That leaves us with Rowan. Pack. Beretta and Jackson. Beretta versus Pack. That already in September, and Beretta won. We also had Pack versus Jackson. We've had Pack versus Jackson a few times, so let's go for Pack versus Beretta. And in theory, that then leaves Nick Jackson against Rowan in the opener. That seems a little unfair. So maybe we'll do Rowan. Maybe we could lend them out. Let's have a look. Because we have a couple of events, as this game says, lined up with a few others this month. So perhaps it'll be cool if I lend out Nick or Rowan. Maybe both. Like, Rowan could go to Ring of Honor. Also not. That's a shame. Oh, you can't send the same one. Right. So, and I think we're looking at two invites. Because I don't want to put Rowan up against Nick Jackson. I think that's a bit unfair. We need to look for a big guy. Haku versus Rowan. Apparently not. Right. Good. Big guy. Not really big guys around here, of course. We also need a fight for Nick. I still want to get chess man in one day. I don't know why, I think it's just a funny name. But okay, what do we have down here? Jake Lee. Kid DeMar is always a solid one to bring. Yano versus Rowan. I wonder if he'd be up for that. That's a shame. Ibushi against Jackson. Okay, well let's first then try and bring someone in, because I can offer a contract still. So who are we going to try for? I still want to try and get a switchblade. Can't win them all. Try again tomorrow. not for Switchblade, but for someone else. So we're back to the invites, which is alright, I can live with that. Chima. Not for that price. The big guy. Marty Skrull again. He didn't get a fair run last month. Knocked out by Cody in 6 minutes. So I don't think that was fair for him. But I don't think we can bring him in straight away again. Bigelow versus Rowan. No. Rowan isn't good enough for that. It won't be a fun match. Harper versus Rowan. Could be. Is Harper King's Road? No, sure. Nick Jackson. Change to give out, but a popularity to Tonka. Brody King. That's Rowan. Let's try and get this guy. Nice. So that was Brian Milonas. Brian Milonas, Kingpin. Okay, that's a pretty nice looking card. 21,000 in expenses. We should sell out 5,000 arena again. But let's wait and see. So first up, we had two big guys kicking things off in Rowan. Briscoe. Nick Jackson. See your heavyweight title because he is injured, so you can't select it. Nice. Okay, so I don't know why it does this sometimes. There we go. So Stevie Richie was in that jacket. Junior heavyweight title. Let's check for Styles. No, they've already sold out. Like nothing. Sold out with a full house. I don't think we can take this anymore. No, we could get close. To go on the road. Like, we just don't have the popularity across Europe. 141 people. Just out of morbid curiosity. It's in Japan. That's where the TV commercial was. Maybe we should do that one day. been on a few shows abroad. It's 31,000, alright. You'd make a small loss. Not now. You'd make a small loss, but you'd make that back again in no time. So we're going to stick with the 100,000 show. With a printout, I can get $40 a ticket. Which would be insane. But we're not going to do that. We're not going to rip people up, it's not what we're here for. So we're going to set out $20 a ticket for the small hall. I think that's fair. So, confirm the card. I think we need to do some stuff in here as well. Merchandise. 1,000 snacks. 1,000 goods. We don't want to dispose of the towels. Well, we sold almost 1,000 towels. Some t-shirts. Let's. So let's give this a save and then we're ready to start the event, which I'm really looking forward to. Okay, so Brian cancelled. Not the end of the world, but how has it hit my attendance? $0.43. Well, it's still on profit, right? 86,000 on ticket sales. Let's just update. No show. So Rowan gets a night off. I'm not too happy, but almost 700 people, so it's the end of the world. But we're in the pre-round, we're in the pre-show merchandise, so we can still recover from that. So let's see, Jay Briscoe, nice and neat direction. First time fight, Jay and Rowan died. Matt, Nick's brother Matt, is defending the junior heavyweight title. In the main event, but he's not at ringside. Not there to help his brother out, so let's see what Nick can do.
Yeah.
Springboard. Springboard missing. Struggled with the match ratings. They've been a little bit out of balance on some of them. And a couple of quick shock results also did me some damage. So I really want to make sure we put on a good show for the crowd tonight, because they've been a bit disappointed. They're still coming to see it. It does harm your reputation, from what I understand. That's something, especially in the first year for AEW, we really want to build up. So, that's the only invite on the card after the no-show from Brian Milonas. So next up, we have Inoue versus Beretta. Two stablemates, so there shouldn't be too much heat in the fight, but they both got the skills to put on a good show. That's what we're after.
Ah! Ah!
Stablemates, just looking for permission, because they're going to be too powerbomb counter. Very nice. 100%. So, let's update the notes here. Beretta and Pinball. Okay. So now we're on to the one match on the cards that I think has the potential to do the matches over the longest in terms of fighting. Cody Rhodes versus Masao Inoue. The risk here is really just that Cody gets another match that move. In this version of Cody, I've downloaded that move, which is pure viciousness. Last week he knocked out Marty Scurll in the main event within 6 minutes, just over 6 minutes. So I'm hoping he gets a bit of a longer run tonight. So here we go, Cody Rhodes versus Masao Inoue. There's no real pressure on this fight. Thank you. clearly rang his bell. An instant classic. Let's hope they don't know.
Thank you.
Fun fight, I enjoyed it. That's for sure. 9%. Okay. I would like to be a little longer, but of course, Omega, been at AEW since the start. Styles the newcomer, so Kenny had to go harder there. Prove his dominance, show why he was the leader of the club. NJPW, as well as, you know, a new guy. Can't let new guys win straight off the bat. But now main event time. Matt Jackson defending the junior heavyweight title and Stevie Richards. Richards won a number one contender spot back in, where was it? In July, when he beat Pac by pinfall. So he's had to wait a few months to get his chance with some guys being in poor condition and just the general shaping of the card. But here we go, can Matt Jackson successfully defend his belt for the first time? Or are we going to see an instant change of hands? the party should mean that the mic audio was prioritized above the game music.
5 minutes gone.
I don't know if it's probably this special streaming straight from the PS4. I don't know the capture card or anything. Yeah. So I've had a lot of issues with the sound quality and sound volume. Sound quality was better yesterday than the right source.
Two.
On a nice even 90% rating for the whole card, which is very good. Big improvement from the last couple of months. And today it's a clean sweep for the Reds. Yesterday it was all blue. We won. Today it was all Reds. That's interesting. Okay, so it's during the fight itself that the mic gets overpowered. So the, in case you missed it at the start, I had a no-show from Brian Milonas, who was sent to kick things off against Rowan. Had he shown up, we would have had a sellout crowd. Apparently there was just over 800 people who only bought tickets to see him fight. Yeah, I wasn't planning on pushing them as singles competitors because they've got the tag belts as well. It's more that I don't have many junior heavyweights. I certainly didn't when I first started up. So I'm looking to sign more junior heavyweights because they can fight for the heavyweight belt. But heavyweights obviously can't fight a weight level down. So it just ended up this way. I hadn't actually expected Matt to beat Pac for the title when he did. So it's just a bit of luck. So I really want to keep the bucks together as much as possible, but obviously, given it's a small company, they are going to get more singles opportunities than you would normally expect. Yeah, it's the biggest profit we've made so far, 57,000, which is great, as we lost some couple of grand from ticket sales with the no-show. So we're cruising towards that 500,000 balance mark, which is the first sort of milestone, really. I really enjoyed it, yeah, it was a good fight. And I think there could definitely be a rematch in the future. Okay, so this month, November, it's going to be December now, we have something scheduled for CMLL, so let's just make a note. Before we end things, the kids are starting to wake up. I can hear them upstairs. Beginning to stir. Sorry for CMLL. Okay, just the one. Well, we can see if I take someone. They refused Nick Jackson this month. Triple H to join ECW. Kevin Nash going to AAA. Well, that's a weird one. Okay, so that empty space is back. Salary's too low. Jack? Right, Jack. Well, Christmas is coming up, so... But I agree, their salaries are too low, so we'll pick up that tomorrow. Or once I'm done here, I might just do that off stream, because that's the sort of stuff that nobody really wants to see. So we're 429,000 in assets, which is nice. So we started off with 150, cruising toward the 500,000 mark. Which is that first milestone. After that, it's the million. And I think once you hit that million mark, then you're kind of set, and you're just going to steadily increase. How do we do on merchandise? We sold out of snacks, sold 800 goods, and sold 700 shirts, which is nice. A couple hundred towels, so we'll stock up on snacks and towels again to the December show, and we'll just let the goods and t-shirts sell out. We won't scrap them and get a whole new bunch of stock in. Next move, I'm not sure. I'm going to have to think about it today with the heavyweight title kind of suspended until the bruise is back. I'm a little bit restricted. So if I can get someone to sign and keep everybody healthy, then I'm thinking we may have the Bucks defend the tag titles in December. Let's have a look. Beretta. Okay, so Beretta and Stevie Richards, so we'll rest those two. Bruce has got one more month out, so we could, if we can get some good invites, we can... yeah, the man's going to fight in Saudi. Who knows, man? I have her downloaded, but I haven't seen it in the game yet. So maybe I have to scout her out, but hey, if she wants to sign, I'm not going to say no. I do have quite a few female wrestlers downloaded, but I don't want to do mixed fights or anything like that, so I want to keep it fair, which would mean I'd have to spend a few months signing just female wrestlers and not have them fight much until we had a decent roster, so maybe we'll try that later on. No, man, Bruiser came in, signed him really as a warm-up act, but he impressed and beat everybody, and worked his way up, earned his title shot the hard way, and pulled off a, quite frankly, a shock win over Omega. So, we need to rest. Who's in Beretta and Richards. But right, I'm going to end it here, because the kids are waking up. Working from home today, so I don't need to head out for the commute, which is great. So I will call it a day and see you all tomorrow morning. Yeah, no, it is fun that you can have the mixed matches, that's for sure. I just want to try and keep it as realistic as possible, especially for now. So I want to shy away from that sort of stuff, but I don't know, like if the right people become available, I may have to. But yeah, you too, man, I will speak to you tomorrow. So what I'm going to do before I leave is I'm just going to host a guy who I watch quite a lot called Ape Fist. He's playing a game called Foundation now, a PC game, so it's a simulation building civilization style, set in medieval times. So let's go host Ape, so you guys can check him out if you're feeling like it, because he's a good guy. There we go. There we go. So Ape's a really good guy. So have fun watching him, and I'll catch everybody tomorrow.